Philip.
Amen.
And Philip introduced the Ethiopian to Jesus.
Amen.
Somebody gonna catch it after that.
Amen.
Also in Acts chapter 8.
All right.
A city held captive by the name of Samaria.
All right.
Believed in God.
All right.
But they had not met
Jesus.
Jesus. So the preacher Philip went to the city of Samaria.
All right.
And introduced the city to Jesus.
Amen.
In Acts chapters 2, 3, and 4.
All right.
The people of Jerusalem believed in God.
All right.
But they had not met
Jesus.
Jesus. So the preachers, led by Peter, introduced Jerusalem to
Jesus.
Somebody
right.
catch it up.
Amen.
And brothers and sisters, in case you have missed it on today, just in case your mind was wandering, just in case you had the itis going on, just in case you was not paying attention,
right.
you have to understand that the scenario, the procedure, and the process
right.
is that believing in God is not sufficient to save us.
All right.
But you got to believe in
Jesus.
Jesus. And according to the story, in order to believe in
Jesus,
there must be.
All right.
Can I tell somebody this?
Come on.
There must be, there has to be, there's got to be a preacher.
All right.
Wish I had a witness here.
Amen.
There's got to be a preacher in the midst.
All right.
For Paul tells the church at Rome, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed?
All right.
And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a, I wish you would hear me here. And so the actions of the apostles, as it is recorded in the Acts, there were folks who believed in God. They knew God. They recognized God. They worshiped God. They went to the Jerusalem temple, gave their tithes, gave their offering, observed the word of God, but it was not sufficient in order to save them.
All right.
God Almighty, for God so loved the
world
that he gave his only begotten Son,
right.
that whosoever believeth in him
right.
shall not perish, but have everlasting life. You got to believe in
Jesus.
And while there are some folks who wish to make the whole realm of theology vague because they don't have any insight. And they wish to say that when we're talking about God, we're talking about Jesus. Brothers and sisters, somebody is missing the boat.
All right. All right.
Can I help somebody?
Come on.
Can I help somebody?
Amen.
I said, can I help? Listen, brothers and sisters. In the Old Testament, it tells us that there is a supreme being.
All right.
Who created the heavens and the earth.
All right.
And Genesis introduces him to us.
All right.
As God.
All right.
I wish you would hear me here.
Amen.
In the Hebrew language, he was El.
All right.
Or Elohim. When we move throughout the Old Testament, there are some passages that refer to him as Yahweh Elohim or Lord God.
All right.
I wish I could talk to somebody
here. Yeah.
But when Jesus came, he says we don't have the same kind of relationship with God that Israel had.
All right.
Because to Israel, God was the God of their father.
All right.
He was the God of Abraham. He was the God of Isaac. He was the God of Jacob.
All right.
He was the God of Joseph.
All right.
To Israel, he was the God of their fathers. I wish I could help somebody.
Amen.
I wish I could talk to somebody.
All right.
And that's why many is they refer to him as the God of their fathers.
All right.
I wish you hear me. But when Jesus came, Jesus says, we have a new relationship.
Amen.
I wish you could talk to me today.
Amen.
Jesus says we don't have a God and his people relationship.
All right.
We now have a more intimate relationship.
All right.
God is no longer just God to us.
All right.
But God is our Father.
Amen. Amen.
And in most instances, when Jesus talked about God, he never called him God.
All right.
He called him the Father.
All right.
I wish I could help somebody.
Amen.
And how stupid it is of us.
All right. Woo.
That with Christian education, we have never picked that up.
All right.
I wish I could talk.
All right.
We have never picked that up. Jesus says we have a new relationship, a relationship that transcends even blood.
All right.
For when Jesus' mama and his brothers and his sisters came to him while he was teaching the scriptures, they interrupted. They interrupted him and said, Lord, your mother, your brother, and your sister is here. And the reason that they had came to see Jesus was because they were concerned about his welfare, because they knew that there was a plot to kill him.
All right.
But rather than Jesus go to his mama, his brother, and his sister and try to comfort them so that they would not worry him, he said, who is my mother? Who is my brother?
All right.
Who is my sister? And then he told us about the relationship.
Amen.
He that doeth the will of my
Father.
That ain't what he said. He said, he that doeth the will of God. Jesus said, he that doeth the will of my Father, the same is my mother, my brother, and my sister. It suggests that the relationship that Christ has ordained transcends blood.
All right.
And if you're going to let blood interfere with your salvation, you're going to die and go to hell.
All right.
Jesus said, God is not God to us. He's our
God.
Matter of fact, he said, when you pray, don't pray, dear God.
All right.
When you pray, because you have a relationship now.
All right.
Yeah, that nobody else has ever had. You address him, you go to him and say, our Father.
All right.
Yeah, because there's special privileges when you're in the family.
All right.
I wish I could help somebody.
Amen.
I wish I could help somebody here.
All right.
And there's some folks in the contemporary church who's content to stay on the outside, waiting for blessings and curses of the Old Testament instead of entering in at the narrow gate that they might receive the intimacy of being a true son and daughter of the Father. When Jesus was telling us, don't worry about our problem, our pain, our situation, our needs, Jesus did not say, God knows what you need.
All right.
What he says is, don't worry, because your heavenly Father.
All right.
I wish I.
All right.
Y'all really don't want me to preach today.
Come on.
Your heavenly Father knows what you need.
All right.
And if your heavenly Father would clothe the lilies of the field, if your heavenly Father would feel